Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 27 of our GoLang course. In this lesson, we are going to cover conditional statements in Go. Conditional statements allow you to control the flow of your program based on certain conditions. These statements include the basic if statement, the extended if-else statement, and a further extension, that is the if-else-if statement. All these statements play a crucial role in decision making within your code. Let's explore these conditional statements in detail. The if statement is a fundamental control structure in programming. It is used to perform conditional checks based on Boolean expressions, which are essentially conditions that evaluate to either true or false. The code block within the if statement is a set of instructions or statements that are executed if the condition specified in the if statement evaluates to true. This means that the code within the if block is only executed when the Boolean expression or condition is true. Here we have an example. As you can see in the example, we define the if statement with if keyword followed by the condition. Here, the condition evaluates whether the variable age is greater than or equal to 18. If this condition is true, the code block following it, that is the code within the curly braces, will be executed. This code block only has one statement, that is FMT println you are an adult. So, in our case, if the condition is true, if age is greater than or equal to 18, we will have you are an adult printed to the console. If the condition is not true, nothing will be printed to the console. Just to revise, we start the if condition with the if keyword, followed by the Boolean expression, followed by the if code block in the curly braces. The if-else statement is a continuation or extension to the if statement we saw earlier. It provides an alternated path of execution when the condition in the if statement evaluates to false. The if-else statement is suitable when there are exactly two conditions that need to be evaluated. It allows the program to take one of the two actions based on whether the condition is true or false. In the if-else construct, there are two separate code blocks associated with it. The first code block that is associated with the if keyword is executed when the condition is true. The second code block that is associated with the else keyword is executed if the condition is false. So just like in our real life where we say if this happened, do this, otherwise do that. Let's look at an example now. Here you can see an example of if-else statement. We start the if-else statement similar to the if statement with the if keyword, then the condition, followed by the if code block in the curly braces. Then the else keyword, followed by the curly braces for the else code block. Here what we are saying is, if age is greater than or equal to 18, print you are an adult. Otherwise, print you are not an adult. So to summarize, if else condition is used when you want to execute two code paths based on the condition. The if else if is an extension or expansion of the basic if-else statement. It allows you to evaluate multiple conditions sequentially. The if-else-if statement is used when you have more than two conditions that you want to evaluate. It's a way to handle series of different scenarios. You can create a chain of if-else-if statements by adding blocks of else-if statements as needed. Each else-if statement allows you to check an additional condition if the previous condition was not met. This way, you can handle a variety of scenarios and execute different code blocks based on what condition is true. Let's look at an example now. Here, as you can see, we have three code blocks. The first is, which says, if age is greater than or equal to 18, execute this statement. Then we check another condition, which says, if age is greater than or equal to 13, then execute this. Then we have the else statement. If none of the above conditions are satisfied, please print the statement. So just to revise, if the condition age greater than or equal to 18 is true, the code written within the first if block will be executed. If that's not true, we check if age is greater than or equal to 13. If that is true, we execute this statement. If none of the above statements are true, we execute this code block. In Go, you can create and initialize a new variable right within the if statement itself. This means you can declare a variable and assign it a value at the same time you are performing the conditional check. When you declare a variable in this way, its scope is limited to the block of code enclosed by the if statement. This means that the variable is only accessible within that specific block and it won't be visible outside it. This Go feature enables you to write more concise and organized code. It allows you to keep the scope of variable localized to where they are actually needed, which leads to a clear and more maintainable code. Let's now look at an example for the same. Here, the if statement begins with an initialization, that is, a new variable even is colon equal to the return value of is even function. We will look at function in a future lesson. In this statement, a new variable named even is created and initialized. After the colon, we have the condition. This means that the code inside the if statement block will execute if even is evaluated to be true. If even is evaluated to be false, we don't execute the statement, just like the if statement. So just to revise, what we are doing here is that we create a new variable scope to the if block, that is, even won't be accessible outside the if block. We then assign even the return value of is even function. And then, followed by the semicolon, we provide the condition for the if block. So in this case, if even is evaluated to be true, the statement age is even will be printed. Now let's summarize what we have learned in this lesson. The if statement in Go allows you to evaluate a condition. Based on the result, either true or false of this condition, specific actions are executed. In situations where there are more than two possible outcomes, Go provides constructs like if-else and if-else-if. These allow you to specify distinct code blocks to be executed based on different conditions. Go offers the flexibility to create and initialize variables directly within the code block of the if statement. These variables are scoped exclusively within the if block. This feature aids in writing more concise and organized code. All these points highlight the versatility of the if statement in Go and how it can be used to make decisions based on the conditions, including scenarios with multiple possible options. Additionally, the ability to initialize variable within the if code blocks provides a convenient way to manage variables in a localized manner. That's it for the lesson. In the next lesson, we will study the if statement with code example. If you have any questions, please leave a comment under the video or reach out through the Discord server. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Happy coding!